Parker arrives on the outskirts of Dawson City to smelt his gold. He's here to see smelter Don Kenzie. Before Parker's gold can be smelted, Don adds flux to the gold ore.
This is soda ash. And the other material we'll add is borax, which is a soap. So once again, you're cleaning the gold.
Don transfers the gold and flux mixture into a heat-resistant crucible. He places it into a furnace that is over 1,370 degrees centigrade.
I've never watched gold being melted or poured or any of that kind of stuff before.
When the gold ore reaches 1,064 degrees, it begins to melt.
What's that for?
This is a carbon rod. What I can do with that rod is give it a feel and see if it's going to liquid nicely, then therefore telling us give it a little more time.
Gold is virtually inert, so doesn't react with the flux, unlike the impurities which combine with the flux and rise to form a slag on the surface. Don pours the red hot gold mixture into a mold lined with vegetable oil, so it doesn't stick.
Stay calm, nobody panic.
As the gold cools, a dark crust forms on the surface. This slag contains iron and a small amount of silver.
Okay, here we go.
Don then breaks the slag from the gold. After 3 months of back-breaking mining, Parker's hard work is boiled down into one solid bar of gold.
34.34 ounces.
All season we worked to get that, and you know, might not be happy with what we got, but it's pretty cool.